Mankind has spent hundreds of years constructing modern cities and places to live. And although we are the dominant life forms on planet Earth, we still come second to Mother Nature. Without warning, natural disasters such as tornadoes, earthquakes, and volcanic eruptions can strike, leaving billions upon billions of dollars in damages in their wake. But nothing compares to the damage done by monster waves, aka tsunamis. Join us in exploring how these titanic disasters can cause hundreds of billions of dollars in damages. What is a tsunami? In layman's terms, tsunamis are large waves caused by immense energy transfers from the Earth into the oceans, which displaces billions of cubic liters of water, resulting in tsunamis that can be hundreds of feet tall. Earthquakes, landslides, and volcanic eruptions are all potential events that could set them off. Tsunamis can travel a distance of up to 310 kilometers, so even if you think you're safe, chances are a tsunami can strike you. The Pacific Ocean is home to the vast majority of tsunamis. Even though this type of natural disaster only happens around twice a year on average, the damage it does can be enormous. Historic tsunamis. While tsunamis have occurred ever since the oceans existed, it wasn't until relatively recently, we're talking in the last several hundred years, that the damage has been accurately documented and recorded by historians. The oldest tsunami we'll talk about occurred on November 1st, 1755, which wreaked havoc on the town of Lisbon, Portugal. Several large earthquakes struck the city on All Saints' Day, meaning most of the population was in a place of worship when the earthquake and subsequent tsunami struck. Over 60,000 people were killed as a direct result of this tragedy, which came to be known as the Great Lisbon Earthquake. Although the economic damage isn't as well known, this event became a seminal turning point in European history, making it one of the most impactful tsunamis on our list. On the other side of the world, in February of 1792, several large earthquakes occurred on Mount Unzen in feudal Japan, on the Fugendake Peak, causing it to erupt and spew lava for a period of 2 months. On May 21st, 1792, one final earthquake collapsed the volcano's dome, which in turn triggered a massive landslide that swept through the city of Shimabara and into a rocky bay. The Maruyama landslide left a permanent scar on the mountainside, and due to the sheer volume of land shifting into the ocean, a mega tsunami was formed and struck Higo Province on the other side of a rocky bay, before bouncing off the city like a rag doll and striking Shimabara again. The waves reached as high as 330 feet, and between the earthquakes, landslide, and tsunami strikes, over 15,000 people lost their lives. While these two tsunamis may seem devastating, they pale in comparison to the other tsunamis we'll talk about. Make sure to keep watching so you don't miss them. Japan has gotten pretty unlucky with their tsunamis. Besides the Mount Unzen eruption we just mentioned, and the number one tsunami we will talk about later, Japan has suffered other famous natural disasters as well. There was the 1896 Senriku tsunami, which claimed the lives of 22,000 people off the back of an 8.5 magnitude earthquake. If you know a thing or two about tsunamis, you know they tend to happen along convergent fault lines, especially those between oceanic tectonic plates. Japan is a super common place for powerful tsunamis to occur, but did you know that on the other side of the world in Southern America, specifically Chile and Peru, is also a common place for tsunamis to strike? In fact, we have three major tsunamis we'd love to share with you guys. The first major tsunami to strike Chile occurred in 1868 in the Arica region of Peru, but now part of Chile. A powerful 9.0 magnitude earthquake struck the region, destroying practically all of southern Peru, including the regions of Arica, Tacna, Moquegua, Molindo, Ilio, Iquique, Torta, and Arequipa. The tsunami also decimated the Chilean coastline, destroying numerous naval ships stationed in the area such as America, Guatari, and Fredonia. In fact, these ships were pushed nearly a kilometer inland due to the waves' incredible forces. The 1868 Chilean tsunami was also responsible for the deaths of 25,000 people. But the tsunamis didn't just affect Chile. In fact, the earthquake was so powerful it sent waves to both Hawaii and New Zealand, causing property damage on both sides of the globe. The next powerful tsunami in Chile was the result of an unprecedented 9.5 magnitude earthquake in 1960, which is known as the Great Chilean Earthquake, aka the most powerful earthquake ever recorded in human history. The earthquake originated 350 miles south of Santiago, off the coast of Lumaco, sending shockwaves that caused tsunamis around the world. Over 6,000 miles away from the epicenter, 35-foot waves decimated the Hilo region in Hawaii. The death toll of the 1960 Chilean earthquake was much fewer than in 1868, with only 2,000 to 6,000 deaths. However, this tsunami was much more expensive, with monetary damages totaling $7 billion when adjusted for inflation. The final Chilean tsunami we would like to mention occurred in 2010, which greatly affected Chile's housing market as it destroyed nearly 400,000 residential homes. Modern tsunamis. Due to our increased technology and data-keeping protocols, most modern earthquakes and tsunamis are very accurately tracked. The two that caused the most financial damage took place in Japan and Indonesia. If you're a younger viewer, you may not remember these two tsunamis being covered on the news, but if you're older, I'm sure you remember watching coverage of the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami. One of the first mega tsunamis to be seen around the globe, the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami was truly a sight to behold. Caused by a whopping 9.1 magnitude earthquake, one of the strongest in modern history, the earthquake generated so much force it raised the entire ocean floor by an astonishing 40 meters, which generated ultra-powerful waves that rose hundreds of feet above the mean ocean level. The fault line that caused the tsunami extended for approximately 900 miles and made landfall on the coasts of India, Sri Lanka, Thailand, and Indonesia. This tsunami was one of the deadliest in modern history, as it swept away 230,000 unlucky individuals into the sea, never to be found again. The tsunami has also found its way into pop culture, with the 2012 movie The Impossible being a dramatized depiction of the events. While the tsunami caused hundreds of thousands in lost lives, the financial damage was roughly $10 billion, which is a crazy high amount, but nothing like the next tsunami we will talk about. If you made it all the way to this part of the video, why not drop a like and comment below? It really helps us out. Without further ado, we would like to share the most expensive tsunami in history, which is also the most expensive natural disaster in history as well. The 2011 Tohoku Earthquake and Tsunami. On March 11, 2011, a 9.0 undersea megathrust earthquake caused a massive tsunami that Japan was not prepared for. Residents had only 8 to 10 minutes to evacuate the 430 mile per hour waves. Considering that the tsunami was so powerful, it traveled nearly 6 miles inland, it is no wonder that over 100 evacuation sites were swept away by the rushing water. The single most powerful earthquake in Japan and the fourth strongest globally created monstrous waves, the tallest of which measured in at 450 feet. The waves traveled at over 435 miles per hour, leaving only death and destruction in their wake. On top of being hit with an earthquake and deadly tsunami, the rushing water directly led to the Fukushima nuclear disaster, one of the worst nuclear accidents since Chernobyl. With all of the factors combined, the total cost of the 2011 Japan tsunami was valued at around $235 billion, making it the single most expensive natural disaster in history. That's it for today. Stay sharp, keep updated on the weather reports, and always stay safe. Thanks for watching. We hope this video expanded your worldview. We'll see you next time.